Yeah, we do use PayStamp and we love it. We also have, this is one of the things I actually love best about having a tech company in Santa Cruz. It's a pretty supportive, cohesive network. I'm also a Yeah Doggy customer. I own two inboards, and I work with Cruise Phone, and when their product comes out, I'll have some of that too. So you guys hopefully all got to see Buoy in the back. For those of you who haven't seen it yet, Buoy is a smart home device that manages household water use. This is important because your house leaks 10% of its water every day. And some of you are sitting there saying, that's not true, not my house. Yeah, it does. Every single house leaks about 10% of its water. Most commonly, it's because of a running toilet that you're not aware of. Sometimes it's a broken sprinkler head. Sometimes it's something else more insidious that's causing damage in your house. But when I learned that statistic 3 years ago, and this was in the height of the drought, and I was being asked to take shorter showers, which I hate because I love long showers, it's a little pleasure I allow myself in the day. I thought, as an engineer, I was just offended. I was offended that we had this inefficiency in the world, that I didn't have good tools to understand where the water was going so I could make budgeting decisions on my own instead of having to make these reactionary decisions every time we have a drought cycle in California. And then I learned that this problem that we're facing in California, like with a lot of things, California is a canary in a coal mine. This is an issue that's facing, that the entire United States is facing and most of the world, because water issues, water scarcity and water prices rising isn't just a factor of weather or groundwater overpumping, it's also a factor of infrastructure and the fact that we need a $1 trillion investment in water infrastructure in this country that we're not gonna make anytime soon. So people in places like Atlanta and San Antonio are paying $300-$400 a month for their water bill when their mortgage is like $1,000, it's crazy. So we built Buoy, and the other thing I wanted to comment on is why we're doing what we're doing, right? Buoy is the first step in toward a vision that we see, where all of us will have more control over where our water source comes from. Weirdly enough, all of us here, you know, have grown up in this tiny little window of time in the United States where we've been able to think that clean water just magically comes out of a tap whenever you open it, and it doesn't cost anything. It was never that way, you know, in the past, and it won't be that way in the future, but what I love about this company and what we're doing is that this particular problem is an ideal problem for technology to come and solve. You know, I've been working in the tech industry for more than 20 years now. When I got my engineering degree, it was really important to me to get to work on things to feel like I was making the world a better place. And sometimes it feels like technology is, you know, a solution searching after a problem. But in this case, when it comes to water, if you have information about how much water you need for different tasks, the same way you have information in your bank account about what you need money for different activities, you can make decisions about how to use it. If we intervene early and shut off your water when you have leaks, we can naturally save 10% of your water use without asking you to make changes in your life. And if we extend from there and start understanding in real time where the demand is in communities for water, we can start looking at different options for sources of water. Because I'll ask you to consider this, you're gonna hear from Inboard next about innovations in transportation. You know, most of us are aware that with innovations like autonomous trucking, autonomous vehicles. I just met a startup last week that's making drones that will do long haul carrying of loads up to 1,000 pounds, like up to 1,000 miles, 1,000 pounds. They're using it to resupply to remote communities with products and goods. You could easily imagine that those resupply, that cargo could be tanks of water. You know, why do we need this infrastructure with gigantic pipes that run underneath cities to deliver clean, potable water to people? So I think Buoy, what we've built today, is something important, and it's the first step toward making everyone self-sufficient with their water use.